Good afternoon and welcome. My name is Betty Ann Gottlieb, and I have been delighted to host this year's Cincinnati String Festival. So welcome to CCM, and thank you for letting us work and learn and make music with your children today. We've been hard at work since 9 a.m. With coachings and rehearsals and lunch at the union. There was even a listening party for the CSO for any of the students who were interested. Before we get started, I would like to recognize some of the personnel that helped to make this event possible. The staff in the offices of performance management and the preparatory department who helped us with the logistics and support. You can't imagine how many chairs we had to wrestle up from around the school to be able to get it into these various locations. So we couldn't make this happen without their creativity and expertise. The behind-the-scenes crew who helped out by putting up signs. Obviously, you all found it, so I'm hoping our signs were helpful. Moving chairs and stands and assisting as needed throughout the day. All of whom are currently undergraduates in music education here at CCM. And many have an emphasis in the string studies, so they helped out with sectionals or they were in taking notes. But some of them wanted to be a part of this because they're in my string class and they wanted to see how a festival like this would work. So their emphases might be in clarinet, piano, trombone, and they are learning how to play a string instrument, so they were fascinated to help out and see what we do with things like this. And we will introduce the coaches toward the end, but we had some wonderful coaches, all of whom are graduates of CCM or currently in a program here at CCM. So before we get started, each piece is going to be introduced by one or two students, and they will tell you a little bit about the piece. And each piece also will be conducted by a completely different conductor, so the students have gotten used to seeing and following a new conductor for each piece, which I think is fantastic for them for learning how to play together. So I hope you enjoy, and our first piece will be Elementals, conducted by Charles Dong.
Our first piece is Elementals. Elementals, by Doug Sparta, is a piece that is inspired by the four elements, earth, wind, fire, and water. Its bold accents and aggressive rhythm intensify the sound, creating a fiery image. Much like the swift winds looming with force, this is a piece to knock you off your feet.
Thank you.
Kyle.
And it is written by Camille Sinsoff. Basically, the song is based off when the spirits come out every Halloween at midnight. The spirits come out and they dance. And in the beginning of the song, you will hear that and listen to it. And at the end, you will hear and see how we present it, that they go straight up to see.
Thank you. and 17th century court dance, typically in double meter, and known for its stately tempo and spirit. In Italy, it was originally used for formal processions at weddings and assemblies, as well as for dancing.
He first imagined Pavane as a piece for his conservatory's orchestra, but later elaborated the scoring to include voices at the suggestion of a wealthy patroness. The piece was further evolved to include costume dancers that were used to enliven the music. The Pavane was first premiered on stage in 1919, but despite its first grand presentation, the Pavane has made its mark more memorably as a concert piece in instrumental form. Its quietly inflected line, delicate harmonies, and haunting melody are just one example of the central French tradition called melody. We now present Fauré's beautiful work, Pavane.
Thank you. by Joseph Campello. It's a lot different than the last piece, which was more peaceful. This is much more exciting, dramatic, and intense. Hope you enjoy it.
Section to section, this G minor arrangement features great dynamic contrast in various tempos. Spider Dance illustrates the story of spiders creeping around a house at midnight to have a little fun. But watch out, will these eerie creatures take over the house or will they be stopped?
Thank you.
So how have you been enjoying this concert so far? They have done a lot of work. I mean, they sounded pretty good this morning when they first came here and had our first hour rehearsal, but I can really hear a difference. All the work that you did in your sectionals, whatever your coaches told you, man, you listen, that's kind of cool. So I hope you will go back and share all the magic that you learned from whoever was your sectional coach, because even though they might have been a bassist teaching the bassist, they probably had something really cool to share with you, and I hope that you'll share that with each other when you get back to school. Just a few cleanup type of items. After the concert, if you are meeting up with your student, we would request that you would meet them in the atrium. Their cases are in one of the classrooms, but they all know where the atrium is, which is the big three-story open area in the middle of the school. And that'll be a very easy place to be able to find each other. So if you would, when you exit the concert, just head to the atrium if you would like to see your child, whether or not they're gonna go back on the bus or if they're going back with you. And if there are any of the students that helped out today, stand in the audience, would you please stand so that we could recognize you? Any students out there that helped out? No, they're probably all unlocking the doors so that they can get back to their cases and working on chairs. So I just wanted to see if I could recognize them. Our coaches here, Stephen Goist or Stephen Nordstrom, Andrew Marabon, who was one of our conductors, was one of our coaches, and Sarah Buell, some of you might remember from Winton Woods, was one of our coaches, and I did one of the strings sectionals as well. So I just wanted to let you know about that. Sarah Buell, would you mind stepping out for a round of applause? Huge thank you to the orchestra directors. Without them and their foresight and coming to put you guys together, this would not have happened. So let's bring out your directors. Miss Angela Jackson from Colerain, Miss Libby Moore from Northwest, and Felipe Morales-Torres from Northwest. Letting us share our day with your children, and here's our final piece.
In the Hall of the Mountain King is a familiar number from a larger work entitled The Peer Gynt Suite. The suite was first performed in 1876 in Christiania, Norway, and is an immediate hit. The movement we are about to perform is likely the most famous part of the score, and it was composed to accompany a scene where the main character was entertained by dancing trolls in the Great Hall of their monarch. The original purpose of the Peer Gynt suite was to be a national epic poem, but today it is more frequently related with the holiday of Halloween. With no further ado, we represent In the Hall of the Mountain King.